of 75th anniversary of Sri Ramachandra Mission and inauguration of world's largest meditation center, accompanied by the Honorable First Lady of India, Srimati Savita Kovind ji and our beloved Daji. We thank all the dignitaries on this stage for unveiling the plaque. And the moment we all have been waiting for is finally here, dear sisters and brothers. Our Honorable President of India, Sri Ramnath Kovind ji, will now address all the 40,000 practitioners of Sri Ramachandra Mission present in this Bhandara and also millions who are watching this program live and on other social media platforms.
Governor of Telangana, Dr. Tamil Sai Soundararajan, Governor of Himachal Pradesh, Sri Bandaru Dattatreya ji, Revered Master Sri Kamlesh Patel Daji ji, thousands of Abhyasis assembled here from all over the world, sisters and brothers. I am very happy to be here on the auspicious occasion of the birth anniversary of venerated Lalaji Maharaj, Adi Guru of Sri Ramachandra Mission. This is also a joyous occasion to celebrate the 75th anniversary of the founding of Sri Ramachandra Mission. I am glad to note that the mission has become a strong spiritual force with the presence in more than 150 countries across the globe. I remember to have read in a book dedicated to Chariji's birth anniversary that when Chariji joined the mission in 1964, the participation of Abhyasis in the Basant celebrations was only about 40, that is 40. Today the number of Abhyasis runs into millions. I have been told that nearly 1,60,000 visitors, mostly Abhyasis, came to this campus from many parts of the world last year alone. Sisters and brothers, spirituality is India's most precious gift to the world. From the teachings of Vedanta, Tirthankar Mahavir and Gautam Buddha, to the messages of Nanak and Kabir, there is a grand flow of eternal spiritual wisdom which was transmitted to the modern world by Swami Vivekananda, Mahatma Gandhi, and many other exemplars of India's spiritual force. Today, Gandhiji is revered all over the world for his message of truth, compassion, and non-violence. Gandhiji was essentially a seeker of spiritual truth. He had once said, and I would like to quote, "I am striving for the kingdom of heaven, which is spiritual deliverance. For me, the road to salvation lies through incessant toil in the service of my country and my humanity." Unquote. I am glad to see that Sri Ramachandra Mission has been promoting both individual change as well as social change. The mission is promoting the great ancient tradition of Raj Yoga, meditation in the modern world. Sisters and brothers, this campus, Kanha Shanti Vanam, presents a model of holistic living. This expansive campus has lush green surroundings, populated by 5 lakh trees. This world-class meditation center is a great place for spiritual rejuvenation. The activity is carried out here for the benefit of women, farmers, artisans and small entrepreneurs, and the steps being taken to conserve and nurture the environment and biodiversity are praiseworthy. I convey my appreciation to Raji ji and all members of Sri Ramchandra Mission for this new global headquarters which has been developed so beautifully. I compliment the efforts for universal well-being taken by the mission. The noble objectives, simple methods, concern for everybody's well-being promoted by the mission enables an ordinary person to achieve extraordinary levels of consciousness and also equips him to make exceptional contribution to the society around him. As we all know, Sri Ramchandra ji Maharaj from Fatehgarh of Uttar Pradesh, fondly remembered as Lala ji, started this spiritual order. It was taken forward by Sri Ramchandra ji of Shahjahanpur, whom we respectfully remember Babuji Maharaj. After Lala ji and Babuji Maharaj, the great responsibility of nurturing and spreading the message of mission was shouldered by Sri Parth Sarthi Raj Gopalachari ji. Or Chari ji Maharaj, whom I always addressed as Master. Chari ji passed on the Master's mantle to Sri Kamlesh Patel ji, whom we all know as Daji. My deep and intimate association with Sri Ramchandra Mission goes back nearly 2 decades. I happen to know Sri Amarjit Singh Jansevak, who was also from my native place Kanpur and also a minister at that time in UP government. In the year 2001, he took me to Chari ji Maharaj in the beautiful natural surroundings of the Satkul Ashram located in Nainital, Uttarakhand. That is what Daji has also mentioned here. Daji ji, you have mentioned the year 2003, but I remember it was most probably 2001 or maybe 2002. But anyway, Chari ji gave me first sitting in that ashram. Later I had the privilege of receiving many personal sittings from him. I often met Chari ji Maharaj at Satkol and in some other places too. Whenever I met him, he would affectionately ask me to sit close to him. In Master's presence, I would always feel that he was working on my spiritual advancement. Even as we were engaged in routine activities like dining together. That is how great masters are. They take care of you without even appearing to be doing so. In the year 2002, I had the opportunity of going to the United Nations as a member of parliament to address the General Assembly in New York. Before going there, I spoke to Chariji and he asked me to meet Mr. Kamlesh Patel. The current master in the US. That is where I first met Daji. It was a warm family get together as I was accompanied by my wife during that visit. Happy recollections of my visit to his house in America are still fresh in my memory. I may share with you, we had a dinner, Gujarati dinner. Sisters and brothers, once Master Chariji wanted me to go to Shahjahanpur and visit the residence and ashram of Babuji Maharaj. I visited those sacred sites. Thus, in a very special way, Master Chariji linked me with his predecessor, Sri Babuji Maharaj, and also Daji, his successor. Sisters and brothers, in the Indian spiritual tradition, Paramarth and Paropkar are interlinked. Seeking ultimate truth is linked to serving fellow human beings. Besides personal evolution, the Indian tradition of spirituality also focuses on the ideals of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam and Sarve Bhavantu Sukhna. For us, the entire world is but one large, well-knit family. We seek happiness for everyone on the planet. This message of universal happiness of the global family is the message of the masters of Sri Ramchandra Mission also. In his illuminating book, Designing Destiny, The Heartfulness Way, Daji refers to a letter written by Babuji Maharaj addressed to the United Nations way back in 1957. That letter was on the subject of world peace. In that letter, Babuji Maharaj had highlighted the method for bringing about the upliftment of the entire universe. Babuji Maharaj had suggested that everyone should sit daily with the thought of all people of the world growing peace-loving and pious. Babuji Maharaj laid emphasis on the virtues of moderation and simplicity. Hence, I would like to quote Babuji Maharaj. I quote, "One of the essentials in the making of a man engaged in a spiritual pursuit is moderation. It is a very wide term and covers every phase of human activity. It means balance in all senses and faculties, nothing more or less than what is naturally required at the time for any specific purpose," unquote. Sahaj Marg is the natural path of moderation and balance. Simplicity is an important aspect of moderation. Simplicity to the point of living life with minimum expectations, minimum needs, and minimum impact on the environment. Babuji had said, "Be simple, live simply, and think simply." On the theme of simplicity, I am reminded of Chari's reference to the good social work done by some NGOs active around his Satkol Ashram. He had especially appreciated some very rich people in those NGOs who adopted very simple lifestyle. Chariji wrote, and I quote, "And there were very big people, rich people, now with a vision. And that vision demands that they are like Gandhi, with minimum clothes, minimum food, and minimum housing. Is this a rule that to produce the maximum, you must be minimum? I suppose it must be." Unquote. Daji has continued the great tradition of the previous three masters, and it is so heartening for the Sri Ramachandra Mission family to see him spreading the great message of the mission farther and wide. He always adheres to the same principles of global well-being which the earlier masters espoused. In fact, Daji has written with great clarity on the idea of upliftment in individual consciousness as a key of global betterment. In a world full of anxieties, uncertainties, insecurities, and hostilities, the responsibilities of organizations like Sri Ramachandra Mission have increased manifold. They can provide the reassuring touch of a healer. In order to effectively play the role of a healer, every Abhyasi has to continuously work for his own improvement. Here, I must refer to the one of the five principles of designing destiny explained so clearly by Daji. He says that to design the destiny of human being, we start with ourselves first and then expand our radius to include others. A day will surely come when together we are capable of changing the direction humanity is taking. Unquote. Sisters and brothers, in order to change the direction of humanity, we need to take on board larger and larger number of young persons and engage them in the endeavors of building a better world. I am confident that the number of people visiting this new headquarters of Sri Ramachandra Mission will keep growing. Here, they will be able to fulfill their urge to make themselves better individuals. I am also sure that the global community of the mission will contribute towards making the planet Earth a better place and transforming humanity into a better community, full of positive energy and happiness. Thank you. Jai Hind.